So the next topic is law of vibration of stressed string. So when the fundamental frequency of vibration of a string fixed at both ends, then it is depend on length, tension and mass of string. That means suppose a string is fixed at a both end and it is vibrating, then their frequency depend on the length, tension and mass of string. How it is vary with the length, tension and mass of string? It is defined by the some law. That law is known as law of vibration of string. The first law is law of length. So what is law of length? So the frequency, because the fundamental frequency of vibration of a string, the string is fixed at both ends, like an example, like this one, is inversely proportional null to length of string. When the tension and mass per unit length is constant, that means if fundamental frequency is f, then it will be inversely proportional to length of string. When tension t and mass per unit length, that is represented by mu, is constant. And second law is law of tension. So what is law of tension? The fundamental frequency of a string is proportional to the square root of its tension. That means the frequency f is directly proportional to the square root of tension. When the length L and mass per unit length mu is constant. The third one is law of mass. What is law of mass? The fundamental frequency of a string is inversely proportional to square root of the linear mass density, or we can say linear mass density is mass per unit length. That means the frequency f is inversely proportional to square root of linear mass density, that is mass per unit length, mu. When tension of a string t and length of a string l is constant. So these are the three law of frequency changing on the length, mass and tension. Now next topic is principle of superposition. So what is principle of superposition? When two or more than two waves can travel simultaneously in medium, without affecting the motion of one another. Therefore, the resultant displacement of each particle of medium at any instant, that means at any time, is equal to vector sum of displacement produced by the two waves. This principle is called principle of superposition. That means two and more than two waves travel in a medium and it is superimposed at a point, then resultant displacement of each particle of medium at any instant can be defined as a vector sum of displacement produced by the two waves. Now the applications of the superposition. That is the applications of the superposition principle, or we can say there is a four applications or four way to superimpose the different waves. So first one is complex wave. What is a complex wave and what is their resultant displacement of the particles? So first we will discuss about the what is a complex wave. So when two waves of different frequency and different amplitude meet at a common point, then the resultant amplitude will be the vector sum of amplitude of individual waves. That means two waves that have a different frequency and different amplitude meet at a point, then the resultant amplitude and we can say resultant displacement of the particle will be the vector sum of the amplitude of the individual waves. Suppose there is a one wave going towards right side and its amplitude is 5 and there is another wave going in a opposite direction and its amplitude is y2, then resultant amplitude will be vector sum of individual waves, that is y1 vector plus y2 vector. In the same way, if one wave is something like that, its amplitude is again y1 and there is another wave that is in a different phase and its amplitude is y2, then resultant amplitude y will be equal to y1 vector minus y2 vector. Now second is interference of wave. In an interference of wave, the two waves have a same frequency and same wavelength. That means when two waves of same frequency and same wavelength moving in a same direction and superimpose at a point, then at some places amplitude will be maximum, or we can say the energy redistribution will be maximum. Energy redistribution and at some places it will be minimum, then this phenomena is called interference of wave. That means if two waves have a same frequency, same wavelength and moving in a same direction is superimposed, then this phenomena is called interference. And if two waves have a different frequency and different amplitude meet at a point, then this type of wave is called complex wave. Now third one is beat. So what is beat? So when two waves of nearly same frequency, but not exactly equal, that means difference between the two frequencies is very less, they have a nearly same frequency, moving in same direction, superimpose, then the amplitude or intensity at a point alternatively will be maximum or minimum. This phenomena is known as beat. Suppose the beat frequency will be equal to difference in frequency of interfering wave. That means if the interfering wave frequencies are f1 and f2, then the beat frequency f will be f1 minus f2. That is the third type of the superposition of the different wave. So two wave have a nearly same frequency superimposed, that is called beat, and beat frequency is equal to difference of the frequency of interfering wave. So there is a last type of wave, that is a standing wave, stationary, or we can say standing wave. So when two waves having same frequency but moving in opposite direction, superimpose, then standing wave is formed. In this case, the frequency of standing wave will be equal to frequency of either of interfering waves. So in this case the frequency of standing wave will be equal to the frequency of individual wave or either of interfering wave, that is called standing wave. So there is a four applications of the superpositions of the principle that have a different amplitude, different same amplitude, same frequency. So this show the four phenomena, four types of the wave. Thank you.